today. From Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City, this is Madden NFL 21 on EA Sports. Cincinnati Bengals.
It is perhaps the best home field advantage in all of football.
Pigeon 30, it seems like your sound alerts browser source is offline. Make sure you've implemented the source correctly or no. Pigeon 30 is now live. Streaming Madden NFL 2-0-2-0-2-0 Vaccine Championship Simulation. Cincinnati Bengals, Kansas City Chiefs.
In Kansas City. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The KC offense set to go, led as always by the gunslinger, a former MVP in this league. It's Patrick Mahomes.
We know the arm strength is certainly there. He's got a big-time cannon for an arm, and that's not a surprise. He's the son of a former major league pitcher, so the bloodlines come into play. The biggest question for Patrick Mahomes, can he harness that big arm, develop the touch that's needed, and carry his team towards the playoffs?
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. They'll set up the screen to Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down.
You know what the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
But you're going to tell me, good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. But first is good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
They fake the give. Now Mahomes taking a deep shot here for Hardman. It's caught inside the 25. And he is finally out of bounds, but he gets all the way down right around the 20.
That's a big-time pitch and catch right there. And, partner, I remember the days when quarterbacks would try this. They were holding their breath. But nowadays, they're counting on their receiver to be just a little bit better than the defensive back when it's one-on-one and the ball's in the air like that.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. They'll run for the first time with Clyde Edwards-Helaire. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
From the 17, Mahomes, and that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion, and to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. Complete. The tight end, Kelce. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. So on fourth down, Mahomes off, Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs field goal. Butker's kick here is good, and the Chiefs are out to a 3-0 lead.
The score, Chiefs 3, Bengals nothing.
Had just the one big play on the drive, but that was enough to put him in field goal range.
Yeah, one big play of what they hope will be many others throughout the game. Every team has a different target for the number of plays like that, those explosives that we talk about. That allowed him to put points on the board on that drive. Let's see how the rest of the game goes.
Harrison Butker.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. To return it, Darius Phillips. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
Take over first and 10.
Here come the Bengals, and CD, of course, it's Joe Burrow out of LSU at quarterback.
What I enjoyed this week is that you asked to talk to his offensive center before the game and find out a little bit more about him and what the relationship is, and that was a pretty positive story, wasn't it?
Yeah, and really what I took away from that is just how it has permeated throughout the entire offensive line, the relationship they've had. It's really a group that's in sync.
They care about him. That's the thing. They really care, and when you care that much, you're going to play that much harder for him and give a better chance to lead the team that wins.
Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll throw from the gun. That one taken in by T. Higgins. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. Escaping the pressure right. And he's going to keep it here. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
3 yards remain for second down. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. He finds his running back, Mixon. And he'll get it down here to the 43. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Jet sweep, Boyd with it. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
As a wideout, when you take that handoff and you're coming around the edge, you're expecting to see nothing but empty space in front of you. But if not...
Well, things can go south in a hurry, and that's exactly what we saw on that play with a loss. First carry for the former Oklahoma Sooner, Joe Mixon. And he's taken down inside the 30. 16 yards, a first down. The CD a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast in the open field, but man, his first step is so quick too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
Okay, ready. On first and 10, Joe Burrow. Slant pass to Boyd. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Brings up nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. Boyd's the target, and he has it over the middle. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
His pass caught at the 4. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. An 11-yard touchdown. And the Bengals have taken the lead. Those are the drives that prove a lot. You got a rookie quarterback, Charles. You're on the road, takes him down, throws the touchdown pass.
And in a game like this, with, as you described, a rookie quarterback, the team usually says, okay, we got to take care of this guy. We got to protect him. But when he goes out and plays like this on the first drive on the road, he doesn't have to say, I'm here to be your leader. They just need to follow him.
And this is up and good to make it 7-3. That time, a 9-play drive. And it ends with a Bengals score. Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. Tyreek Hill set to return it. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Mahomes now on first down. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Not the kind of gain that we'll go absolutely crazy for, but it's the kind of gain that you need to have when you're running back in the NFL and Clyde Edwards-Helaire with that low center of gravity and strength. He's going to get those tough, gritty yards for you when necessary.
From the 44, Mahomes. Ball hit as he throws there, incomplete. Mecole Hardman, the intended target, and it's 3rd down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
On 4th down, Tommy Townsend to punt for Kansas City. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Cincinnati coming back onto the field here for their 2nd drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Burrow and the Bengals with a 1st and 10 at the 20. He'll hand it off here. This is Mixon. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up 2nd down.
He was taken down at the
22. Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24.
On the carry.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
3rd down.
Now on 3rd down, an extra DB out there for the Chiefs. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. He's got his man, Boyd. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A Bengal 1st down on the 16-yard pickup there.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Burrow going to fake to mix it and now look to throw. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack. Melvin Ingram dropping the hammer off the edge.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front, nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's 2nd and 20. 53, 53. Burrow looking to pass. This pass complete to Higgins. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a 1st down.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Had a little arc on it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play on the football.
So now 1st and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 44-yard line. Here's Burrow. That's caught by the tight end, Drew Sample. 7 yards, the pickup there.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. They go back to the ground now with Mixon. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go.
No gain on the play.
Quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the 2nd and the 3rd level.
Now a throw left sideline here is complete. He had the touchdown on the opening drive. Now he's got a 1st down.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the 1st down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
Yeah, they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Now Joe Mixon. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on 1st down.
On 2nd down, Burrow, open man is Higgins. And he lost the football, and it's picked up by the Chiefs. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball, you know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
And now here comes Kansas City, and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win 1st down. You win 2nd down. And guess what? You start accumulating 1st downs, and that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
So they need to determine if that knee was down before the ball was coughed up.
And they also wanted to make sure that the ball was possessed as they were going through, that the ball wasn't working its way free before the knee hit the ground.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's 1st and 10. Now Burrow. And his throw is incomplete.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Now it's Burrow. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
Once you get into the red zone, space is at a premium for receivers to try and operate and shake themselves free. That one's incomplete.
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is 3rd and long. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. And it's caught. And the Bengals are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Well, we could talk about it like it's just a basic route, but how about the timing on this one? Lined up on the right, runs a deep in route, and how about the throw? Right on the money. Bam! Puts it right in there and on his hands. Nice completion. Really good pickup.
Mixon trying to punch it in, and he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Bengals, they widen their lead. A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know that sounds really generic, and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front, offensive line, collective victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
Seibert on for the PAT. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. A drive there of just 4 plays. And it all culminated in the touchdown run coming from Joe Mixon. Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. Here's the dangerous Tyreek Hill. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not on a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Mahomes now to throw. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down.
At the 39-yard line.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. A gain of 6 there on first. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down. Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down to the 46. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
After one, a 14-3 ball game.
Your Bengals 14, Chiefs 3.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49. Larry Ogunjobi in for the sack.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big. But sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack.
57, Mike, where's Hunt?
Another try after the first down sack. Mahomes flushed out right, finding room inside the 40. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 29-yard line. No one there to help out downfield, but no problem. Scrambling for 22 and a first.
The sack on first down took him out of a traditional running play and put him in a passing situation, but didn't stop him from running anyway, did it?
No, I was surprised when he took off. I thought, oh, he's got some space. He might pick up 5, 6, 7 yards. He goes all the way and picks up the first. So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 as they're down to the 29-yard line. Now a carry for Edwards-Helaire. And only able to muster a couple down to about the 27.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
On play action, it's Mahomes going for it all. And he's got it. Touchdown, Chiefs. Mecole Hardman, 27 yards. And the Chiefs are able to get this back within a touchdown.
Sometimes when I see these types of plays executed, I think of basketball. Guys boxing other guys off to go out and get a rebound.
And he got the rebound right there. But the defense was really placed well.
Yeah, they were right there. I mean, that's where it's really tough for a defender. When you're in the right spot, you're draped on the guy catching the ball, yet he still comes down with it.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. He's got it. That cuts the lead. It's now 14-10. So that drive goes 8 plays. And it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. After the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there.
At their own 26-yard line.
Here again comes Joe Burrow in the offense for the Bengals. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number 2 here in the second quarter. Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10 at their own 26. Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath. Settle down and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Now Burrow to throw on second down. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
Mixon with a first down carry. Strong run, but he's corralled just beyond the 40. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On second down, here's Burrow. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
He did a fine job there not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Now he's going to send this one deep, and that's caught inside the 30. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Call that a gain of 38, a big march forward on the third down conversion.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process, and really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and accuracy.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Now it's Burrow. Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzama. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Now, coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Melvin Ingram picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
Well, they had the right down and the definite distance to take a shot downfield, but it didn't work out the way that they had envisioned.
No, that's a situation where if you take a sack close to the line of scrimmage, it's not that bad, but a loss like that, you can't take a sack there.
Yeah, absolutely. The one thing you cannot do, they did.
Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7. Burrow will throw. Eluding the pressure right. Burrow on his toes that time as they get the first down.
First and goal at the.
Now that's disappointing for the defense. They had the advantage, had excellent coverage all over the field, but they let him get away, scramble, and pick up a first down and inside the 5-yard line.
Here's a run with Mixon. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
That's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there forcing a loss on that play.
From back
at the four. Here's second and goal. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. From 4 yards out. And the Bengals add on to their lead.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run and he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Here's Seibert now to add the extra point. It's good, and it's 21-10. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it's finished off with a Cincinnati touchdown. Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. Tyreek Hill on the return. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
The Chiefs take over first and 10.
The Chiefs' offense set to go. Their passing game has certainly been buoyed by some unbelievable catches.
I love that word, because if you're the quarterback, if you're the guy throwing it, buoyed would be the word, wouldn't it? Because right now, I think his confidence level is so high. I just throw it out there. They will go get it. And we're seeing some fantastic catches and some great plays as a result.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And that last touchdown drive, a good mix of pass and run. Defensively, they just looked a little out of whack.
And it's so hard to stay up with an offense that has things going so well, where you're guessing and guessing wrong play after play. So what you need is someone on the defensive side of the ball to make a big play. Throw that balance out of whack. That's what you're looking for now. Not worrying so much about guessing what the play call is.
Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down.
57 to Mike. Let's go.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. A quick slant to Hill. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. The catch and run, good for 24 yards. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Working from the gun, Mahomes. Complete, the tight end, Kelce. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. And incomplete on the deep ball. His favorite target, Travis Kelce, the intended receiver. And it's third and short.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
The Chiefs on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. Here it's third and two.
Watch twist. Watch.
They'll run here with Edwards-Helaire.
And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. It'll be called a gain of two, and that'll leave him with some options here on fourth and inches.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Would have been a decently long field goal, 51 yards from here, but instead they're going to go for it. They'll go. It's Edwards-Helaire. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. They only got a couple, but a couple is all that they needed as they convert on fourth. Just enough push up front. He only needed about 6 inches. He didn't get a whole lot more than that.
No, but he made sure he got enough so they didn't have to worry about measuring it or making it even close. Ends up picking up a couple of yards in a situation, as you noted, where he only needed inches.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now a toss left side for Edwards-Helaire. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet. 34-yard line.
A small bit of adversity here on what's been a strong drive as they come up second and 12. Now they'll throw with Mahomes. Completes it to Hardman. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
The Chiefs on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This time they face a 3rd and 2. And it's complete to Kelce. And he will have a Chiefs first down. It's a gain of 6 that time on 3rd and 2. 5th catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. Sam Hubbard making his presence felt in the backfield. And it's never good to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. But you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you back and try and take you out of that.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on 2nd down. Another try after the 1st down sack. Mahomes. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
Well, they certainly did a nice job there picking him up out of the backfield and then running stride for stride with him. That's good coverage, and it led to an incompletion.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Here's Mahomes to throw. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Harrison Butker for the Chiefs field goal. A 44-yard attempt.
Butker's kick here is good. And that'll make this an 8-point game.
Makes the score Bengals 21. Chiefs 13.
So they get three, certainly hoping for six after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job there. But here's the other part. 13 plays, you don't force any mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Joe Mixon and the rest of his offense making their way back onto the field. The passing game, they've had more success there than the running game. Maybe something they game plan for.
How come they didn't tell us about it?
Because they wanted to keep it a secret.
We did ask, didn't we? But I think what happened in this one is they've realized that they've established the run pretty well, and teams are going to key on that. They thought they could open it up and have success through the air, and that's exactly what's going on.
Yeah, they've had success at least so far here in the second quarter.
Burrow and the Bengals with a first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Off play action, he'll throw to start the drive.
His throw is going to be incomplete. Tyler Boyd, the former Pitt Panther, was the target. That'll bring up second down.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. From the gun, a give to Mixon. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37, gain of 9. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the close fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. Just a one-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down.
From this vantage point, they've got the lead here, so for me, that'd be enough to go ahead and punt the football and let my defense defend the long field.
If you go for it, you don't get it, then you really put your defense in a tight spot.
Yeah, but we never know what people ultimately will decide to do here on fourth and inches.
Fourth down, on comes the left-footed punter, Kevin Huber, to punt it away. Tyreek Hill back deep for Kansas City. Taken in at the 22. That'll go as a 39-yard punt. Give him 9 on the return. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Out comes Patrick Mahomes in the Chiefs offense. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but bottom line, his team's losing. They got to fix something.
And it starts with him. He has to keep that little quarterback strut going right now to make sure that his team sees him as confident. Continue to try and up his game, but just let them know, hey, if I'm around, if I'm the one calling signals and throwing the football, just follow me, we'll get there. Sometimes that will do more to elevate a team than anything else.
See if he has that confidence. A good start to the drive here as that's caught out on the left side. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 25 yards that time.
Press coverage on the outside, and for defenders, that's the ultimate risk-reward. If you take the risk, can you reward yourself by keeping them on the line of scrimmage? But no, not on that one. Got the step on him. Now it's just a matter of laying the ball out there for him to go get it.
Mahomes now on first down. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
That was a really nice interception. I think it illustrates the differences between playing man and playing zone. When you're in man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes and go to the ball. That's exactly what happened on that play.
Joe Burrow trots out again with the rest of his offense. And he's been good. Two first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
They will throw on first down with Burrow, and this is incomplete. And this will be well too low for him to bring in. It's incomplete.
Brings up second and 10 at the 20-yard line.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. And the Chiefs are going to get him. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here's Kevin Huber now as he'll kick it away for the second time. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Patrick Mahomes on his way out for their next drive. He's had a solid start to this game, but bottom line is they're losing, so he doesn't care about his stats. He just wants to right the ship on the scoreboard.
He wants to actually increase his stats because he feels like if he does, that means things will get better for his team, maybe get them back into the ball game or into the lead. In these situations, I remember playing with a quarterback once where he actually ran out onto the field first ahead of everyone else just to say, guys, let's go. Try and create that energy, create that spark.
Well, so far he has one touchdown, one interception. He'll be looking. Well, Mahomes can't get away, and down he goes. The Clemson product, DJ Reader, got in for the sack.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been under constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. And going deep for Hill. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench into what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
On third down, here's Edwards-Helaire. Room to run past midfield. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. The defense shaking their heads, not aggressive enough, and they allow him to convert a third and 18.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. Throwing now is Mahomes. That one complete to Hill. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Now a timeout. 7 seconds left in the first half. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. From the right hash, this from 53. And that is no good. He gave it a good run. That wasn't more than a foot or so wide to the left. And this score will stay right where it is. And that's the risk of the long field goal miss here at this stage of the second quarter. You give up great field position.
And that gives them one more opportunity to make something happen and something big. And we've seen crazy stuff happen at the end of halves.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
So we have reached halftime here in what's an 8-point game. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. We just watched a strong first half out of the rookie from LSU. He's thrown for close to 200 yards already, and that's helped propel his guys into the lead. As we send you back to Brandon Godden.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Three. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
The Bengal offense now with the football first here to begin quarter number three. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
See if they do just that. Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here first and 10 at their own 27. He fakes the give here and looks to throw. Able to find Higgins. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A big play on the catch and run, covering 34 yards.
So when's the best time to take the big shots downfield? When you think a defense least expects it, and I think the first play of the third quarter qualifies. They came right out firing. That's how you send a message to start the second half of a game.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Jet sweep, Boyd with it. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Well, they gave up a few yards there, but all in all, I think it's a pretty nice job defensively against the jet sweep. If they don't slow him up, he might take it to the house, so they'll take that play every time on the defensive side of the ball.
On second down, here's Mixon. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
in need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Once again, they run with Mixon. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down.
I apologize in advance, partner, but the beef eaters on the interior of this D-line, you just know they were licking their chops on third and short. And yes, they were rewarded with a tasty dish, stuffing that one short of a first down.
This would have been a 48-yarder, but no, they're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it with Burrow. He's got his man, Boyd. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a first down, his fourth catch of the game after having three in the first half. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets, because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Out of the shotgun, they run with Mixon. And he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. They'll stay on the ground, Mixon again. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six. It's a five-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. This will be play number seven on the drive, third and a yard. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. This will be caught at about the five. And the Bengals are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. The gain of five that time gives them the conversion and makes it first and goal.
And that one was a lot of fun right there, because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
They'll give it to Mixon, and this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the four-yard line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Well, it's apparent the defense understands the situation. They have to keep them out of the end zone here. That's a great start by them. A loss on that play. Can they force them into a field goal attempt and still give their offense an opportunity?
Back at the four, here's second and goal. Now Burrow. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. C.J. Uzama, a beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Bengals are able to grow their lead.
And remember, partner, that's a rookie quarterback back there. Apparently, he's getting the hang of this NFL thing pretty quickly.
At three touchdown passes. You're right. He looks comfortable. What are they doing? Anything in particular?
Well, they keep talking about making sure they're giving him plays that fit his talents and also maybe shrinking the playbook a little bit. They did tell us that. Bottom line, he's really good.
And the lead is up to 15 now. A 10-play drive that time. And it ends with a Bengals score.
Chiefs 13.
following the touchdown. Here's Seibert now to kick it off. Returning it, Hill. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
Now whistles, and we've got a man down. A man down here following the kickoff. We'll step aside and get an update when we return to Arrowhead. Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Mahomes hit. He lost the football.
Joe Burrow sack. A fumble on the play.
Fortunate to get that football back, because trailing here in the second half, last thing they needed was to lose the possession.
And the word I think of here is opportunity, because it could have been lost there, their chance to score points. But the opportunity for the defense was to go ahead and really close this game down if they were able to get possession.
So they keep the ball, but work to do on second and long. To throw, it's Mahomes. And the pressure gets to him again. Trey Hendrickson. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
After the sack, things get a little tougher here. Third and long for Mahomes and the Chiefs. Mahomes now to throw. And he's going to go down again. Sam Hubbard able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
You got 2-1.
Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And a fair catch taken back near about the 35, 36-yard line. 37 yards on the punt with no return. And the Bengals will take over here first and 10. Here again comes Joe Burrow in the offense for the Bengals.
How do you think he personally is evaluating his game so far? He was pretty good in the first half, been good so far here in the third quarter. He's got to like it, right?
Not looking for the dramatics here. Not trying to set the world on fire in terms of stats. It's almost like you're driving. Hands at 10-2, alert for anything out there, watching for trouble on the road, and making sure you get the team home.
The bus driver. See if he can drive the bus here again on this drive. He was brought down there by Will Parks.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
Number one. 5 yards on the
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Third and two, now Burrow. Flush to his, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Chris Jones coming in to drop it for a loss of 8, and it also brings up 4th.
Brandon, more often than not, you'd say they've had his number, and we can count them up so far. 1, 2, 3, 4 sacks given up. But guess what? He's still been able to make some plays, and right now they have a lead.
Here's Kevin Huber now, as he's on to punt for Cincinnati. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and out will come the offense as they take over. The Chiefs ready to rock again on offense. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 23. Here's Edwards-Helaire as they will start on the ground. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
The last run got 6. Now 2nd and 4. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Caught, Kelce, left side. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 14 on that one, and a first down.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
Mahomes now on first down. Gets this one to Hill. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
And the hitch route has run really well. That jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space. All you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage. And that's exactly what he got done there.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a 1st and 10 right at the 40. They go play action. Now Mahomes. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. It was Ricardo Allen there on the coverage.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now we had a guy who made the catch. They tried to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
So 2nd down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Mahomes to throw once more. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Here's Edwards-Helaire, and he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. A 3rd down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
And that's why you spend a first-round draft pick on a running back, not for just the fancy runs, but these dirty, gritty third-and-ones, third-and-twos. That's why you draft him.
Here on first and 10.
Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31.
A loss of two.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
Following the sack, they'll come up here on a second down and 12. Another try after the first down sack. Mahomes complete, the tight end Kelsey. And it's a fumble, and the Bengals grab it. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S, ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock.
So we've got a challenge. Our referee's going to take another look on the tablet. He's going to be watching to see if the knee was down prior to the ball coming out.
Oh, I love what you just said there. You nailed it, because if the ball's shifting or moving before the knee or any other part of the body hits the ground, then that'll be considered a fumble.
So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Now after the fumble recovery, it's Mahomes being chased out left and out of bounds right around the 20. The decision to tuck and run gets him 3, but that's not enough. Now it's 4th.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
So on 4th down, Mahomes off, Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs field goal. From the left hash, this from 37. Butker's kick here is good. And they're hanging around here as the lead's down to 12.
Makes the score Bengals 28, Chiefs 16.
So as it turns out, a 2-play drive resulting in the field goal. So his 3rd field goal of the ball game brings him a bit closer, but there's no question they need to start turning some of these 3s into 6s.
And 7s, and probably even 8s. You know, as a kicker, you just head out when you're called upon, so he's done his job. It's the rest of the offense that needs to get it in gear if they want to close this gap.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. On the return, Phillips. And able to get this out to the 25.
Over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Joe Mixon and the Bengal offense ready to go back to work. He's had a good performance, moved the ball effectively on the ground. Of course, he has the 1 touchdown.
And when you're able to move it as effectively as you've described, that leads to finding a way into the end zone, and now he's just trying to do it for a 2nd time. And, of course, with that comes additional yardage.
Yeah, looking for additional yardage, and again, that 2nd score here in the 3rd quarter. Burrow and the Bengals with a 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. He's back to throw here to start the drive. That's taken in by Higgins.
And they work this well upfield across the 45. A nice gain of 21 yards.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Here's Burrow. Boyd's the target, and he hands it over the middle. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Now Burrow on first down. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
A third quarter action from Kansas City, second down and 10. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And he'll take this close to a first down at the Chiefs 33. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
And that's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And, you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the chirping. Right now I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. We are right there about to break a big one.
On third and one, Burrow. Oh, they would have gotten a conversion if he could hold on. Instead, the drop means it'll be fourth down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
So they'll say no to the 50-yard field goal try. Instead, the offense out there, they're going for it. They'll run with Mixon. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. They only needed a few inches, and they didn't get much more than that. But by about the width of a shoelace, they convert on fourth down. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now Joe Mixon. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
7-yard line. A gain of five brings up second and five.
Five yards remain on second down, and they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second down now. Mixon, and he'll take this close to a first down at the Chiefs' 19-yard line. It goes as a gain of eight, and it moves the chains.
I think there's a fatigue factor that's kicking in defensively. You know the will is still strong, but I think the offense is starting to bend it just a little bit, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely. It's looked that way. We'll see if they can continue this already strong drive. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
Thank you for following the Joe Biden.
On the delay, it's Mixon. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of nine on first down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And now they will throw it with Burrow. Steps away to his... And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. A 10-yard touchdown run. And the Bengals, they widen their lead. I'm pretty sure that that was a passing play, but he took off pretty quickly and ran with it.
Love his decisiveness on it, because you're exactly right. He was supposed to go back in the pocket and survey the field and throw the football. But when that hole opened, he just said, forget it, let's go. And boy, did that work out well.
Cybered on for the PAT. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So the drive goes 75 yards, 10 plays. And it was Joe Burrow who took it himself for the touchdown run. Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. The dangerous Hill now to return. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
KC's offense ready to take over. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
Looking for the big chunk now, because as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6 and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 22. And from the shotgun, he'll throw. To the right side, it's Kelce. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. From the gun, it's Mahomes. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 11 yards there, first down. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
On first down, Mahomes. He'll find Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Call it a pickup of 7, and it'll be second down. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. Escaping the pressure right. And now he's going to use his legs. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3. But now it's third down.
Now how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
The Chiefs on third down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. Working from the gun, Mahomes. He's got his man, that's Hardman. And he will have a Chiefs first down, and he'll have it by plenty as they're able to keep the drive alive on third and inches.
If guard that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect. So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Now here's Mahomes. That to his running back, Edwards-Helaire. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 24-yard line. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in his performance.
First down is Mahomes. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And again, it's Mahomes. Flushed out. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. An 8-yard touchdown run. And the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead.
Well, I'd have to say that for him, that was an all-encompassing drive because it was his arm that got his team down to that point, but his legs that finished the deal. Give him credit for making it happen.
Butker now to add the extra point. Cut the deficit to 12. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it was all capped by Patrick Mahomes using his legs to get in the end zone. Touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. Well, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll hand it off here. This is Mixon. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 yards there and a first down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now Mixon. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
That gives him 98 yards in this game, and he's got to feel pretty good about that, but the entire offense does. The big thing, though, Brandon, they've got to get to 100, though.
You think he knows he's at 98?
I think someone has told him by now. And here's the thing. Getting to 100 or more is tangible evidence that you've had a nice day running the football, and that's what his offensive line wants for him and for themselves.
Over the middle, complete. It's Boyd. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
And it's third down.
On third down, Mixon. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a 4th and 1. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
Here's Kevin Huber now, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today. And a nice job here to down this one right on the 5-yard line. They decide against going for it on 4th and 1, maybe to the dismay of their offense, but hey, a nice consolation prize down inside the 5.
Nice consolation prize indeed. So maybe the offense is upset, but they showed confidence in their defense by punting it away.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a 2-score game, and they need points on this drive and in a relatively quick manner. The drive will begin with a run by Edwards-Helaire. He's going to have the first down past the 20 and finally taken down to the 26-yard line. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Mahomes now on first down. He'll find his running back, Edwards-Helaire. It's a gain of 7, and that'll make this a 2nd down. 4th quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the 2nd touchdown. You got the 1st one for the 2nd one to even matter.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Mahomes is going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain there of 21 yards.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple of scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks, and they know the defense doesn't want to give those up. They've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 46. Now Mahomes. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That's back-to-back plays of over 20 yards. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
Mahomes now on first down. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target. And it's second down. I want to go back to something you said in the first quarter about winning.
Is it a positive?
It is a positive.
Okay.
About winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. You were right. They've done just that, and look where it's gotten them.
It's part of the formula. When you go on the road, as you mentioned, being an underdog, winning the turnover battle is a big key, and this one's playing out in this one.
Mahomes again here on second and 10. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tough for guys trying to get to the football.
The Chiefs on 3rd down. They've converted 5 times in their many chances thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. From 3 yards out, and the Chiefs are able to get this back within a touchdown.
Okay, I know it's an old line, but it still applies here. The fat lady has not sung yet. She may be warming up, but she hasn't sung yet. There's still an opportunity.
Butker on for the PAT. This is back to a 5-point game. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The Bengal offense now gets set to head back out onto the field. This game has really flipped on its head. 2 unanswered touchdowns by the other side, and now Yeah, they take over here with just a very slim one-score lead.
And we've seen this how many times now? Teams get a big lead, they go into coast mode, and all of a sudden they're scrambling and battling for a win down the stretch. They've got to put something together right here, otherwise they're in danger of doing the old snatching defeat from the jaws of victory.
Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Second and nine at the 26-yard line.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Again, it's Mixon. Call it a gain of five that time, and they'll be left with a third and about four.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four. Now it's Burrow. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A Bengal first down on the 16-yard pickup there. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way, it worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Try to eat some clock with Mixon. He'll get three up to midfield. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Again, it's Mixon. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Now it's Burrow. Eluding the pressure right. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Here's Kevin Huber now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. Patrick Mahomes in the offense. Down by five, a minute 45 to play. Needing to go pretty much the length of the football field as they have it first and 10. Throw. That one complete to Hill. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. A solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
That gets him the first down, but they've still got to move quickly here.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Mahomes to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards. Obviously a big first down right there.
Yeah, they still got to hustle. They got to get up to the line of scrimmage and get set. But I don't think necessarily you need to spike it, but they've got to continue to move quickly.
Mahomes used to moving quickly in college, trying to get his guys to the line. To throw is Mahomes. Completes it to Hardman. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Gosh, given the time and the short game, would he have been better off just dropping that?
Yeah, when you look at the clock, you think so. But it's hard to get a receiver to drop a football. They're trained to catch everything.
The Chiefs will try and get to the line quickly. Back to throw. Middle of the field, it's Robinson. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. Throw Mahomes, now a desperation throw deep downfield, and he can't hang on to it. That would have sealed it. Instead, second down.
Jesse Bates on the coverage.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Now Mahomes. He's going to let it fly. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Cheetah Bay Awuzie with a pick.
Intercepted by the Bengals. They'll take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Down to a knee, and that should be the final act of this one. So this one in the win column now for the Cincinnati Bengals. And, of course, this is a win they're going to hang their hat on. They go on the road and defeat the defending Super Bowl champs.
Partner, they came, they saw, they conquered.
They conquered.
But before all that happened with the conquering part, they believed. They thought it all week. It was evident when we talked to them before the ball game that they thought they could get this done, and they knew exactly how, had a plan, formulated it, and then executed it as a big-time win to take down the defending Super Bowl champs.
Just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. From Kansas City, so long, everybody.